Well, again, welcome. My name is Frank Alaniz, for those of you who don't know me. I'm a workforce development program professional. I've been doing this forever, it seems like. But what we're going to do today is we're going to take a little different track. We're going to talk about advanced LinkedIn. Our last workshop was about LinkedIn basics, how to get up and running and how to get started. Today's workshop is taking it to the next level. And so we're going to kind of work within that parameter. Let's see if I can get this to work. Nope. So let's try this one. There we go. So best LinkedIn profile ever. In all reality, you can see Anakin Skywalker, assistant to the Emperor. Or if you were to look at Anakin on LinkedIn, you would see Darth Vader, Lord, CEO of the Death Star 1 and 2, and keep going and going and going. And so I found this on LinkedIn in a LinkedIn program workshop. And so this kind of gave me the idea of kind of what to do and how to take it to next steps. So today's topic, it's really simple. We're going to talk about SEO, search engine optimized. In order to be found on LinkedIn, you have to do things correctly. The next step, so the next thing we're going to be talking about is being found. So once you have your profile optimized, what happens next? And then the last thing that we're going to talk about is what you need to do today in order to move forward in the process. So SEO, or search engine optimized. There are 5 LinkedIn profiles that are out there today. Number one is the beginner profile. All right, so that's a person that just basically, whether it was 5 years ago, 2 years ago, or last week, just went on LinkedIn and kind of filled in the blanks. Then there's the intermediate profile, and that's the individual that basically has done a little bit of work, you know, friends and family and coworkers or whoever said, oh, you need to add this to your LinkedIn profile. So they kind of got started. And then we have the advanced LinkedIn individual, that person who is truly trying to move forward. And then we have an expert, okay? And then finally, the all-star. All right. And our goal on LinkedIn is to move forward on that and be an all-star. Why? So that you can be found. All-star or SEO, all-star profiles are 40 times more likely to be contacted about job opportunities and 18 times more likely to show up in search results based on all the other profile levels that we've already talked about. And it's real simple. This morning, I'm an all-star. What does that mean? I don't know. I'm not looking for a job, but LinkedIn sent me an email this morning, said you matched for 65 different jobs. What does that mean? I don't know. I deleted the email. I guess I should have looked since we, you know, choices, yes. But here's the thing. Being at that SEO level, search engine optimized level, opens a lot of doors on LinkedIn that we need to start thinking about if we're going to move either us or our clients further. So to be search engine optimized, the number one component is keywords. Use keywords associated with the position you are sourcing for versus past positions. So if you are a workforce professional and you don't want to do that anymore, you want to be a training professional, then what you need to do is optimize your keywords to show that you are a training person, training and development, versus a workforce person. I see this all the time, and I talk to people. As a matter of fact, last week I had a long conversation with my daughter who doesn't want to be a teacher anymore. So I looked at her LinkedIn profile and it says you're a teacher. Well, that's what I do today, but that's not what I want to do tomorrow. Well, then let's remake this. No, I like what it, and I said, well, okay, well, then you're always going to be a teacher, you know. Some areas to add keywords. The number one, headline. When I do a search for an individual on their LinkedIn profile, the first thing that shows up is your headline. The next section is your about section. That's the place where you can tell your story. And of course, experience, recommendations. When you're doing recommendations or you request a recommendation from somebody, fill it full of keywords. And then of course, the skills section. Excuse me, it's coffee time. Now, in order to be search engine optimized, the first thing you have to do is complete your profile. Number one thing on a LinkedIn profile is a photo. We're not asking for anything that's, you know, over the top. You don't have to go get a professional photo done, but it needs to be business centric. All right. So if your job requires that you call, that you wear a business outfit, a business suit, you know, tailored, whatever it is, their picture must contain that. If you were like my picture, you know, most of my last jobs required business casual. So my photo is business casual. The next thing you need is a headline. So you have 120 characters in your headline, use them all, all right? And also, again, like we talked about last time we met, searching for my next career is not a headline. I guarantee no one is ever gonna type into LinkedIn, wonder who's searching for their next career, all right? Your about section, you have 2,600 characters. Okay, if you take a look at my profile, my LinkedIn profile, and you look at my about section, it contains 1,800 keywords out of the 2,600. I'm sorry, 800 keywords, not 1,800. Out of the 2,600 keywords that I've used. All right, so again, it makes me findable. Experience, your last two jobs or the last 10 years. Now, if you are long-term or if you are long-term employed with one organization, my recommendation is go back 10 years ago. What were you doing with that organization 10 years ago? And that's where you're going to start your profile, all right? Skills, you must have 50 skills, all right? LinkedIn allows you to have 50 skills, so utilize them all. One per visa, do not put outdated skills or software, okay, in your skill section. Because it's all about relevancy today. Me as a recruiter, if I'm looking at your profile, you know, and I see you have Lotus Notes, when there's only two companies in that I know of in St. Louis, there may be more, that utilize Lotus Notes, I can't use you. I need somebody with a Google Docs experience, or I need somebody with Microsoft experience, and Lotus Notes is neither of those. All right? Education. And be cognizant, turn that education into a job, fill it full of keywords. Recommendation, you need at least one recommendation on your profile. My recommendation for that is real simple. Write the recommendation for somebody you wish to have recommend you. Send it to them via LinkedIn. Would you recommend to me? Oh, by the way, here's a synopsis. Let them edit it. Send it back to you. You proof it. If you like it, post it. All right. It will save you a lot of time and trouble. All right. Volunteer status, especially if you're in the metro area. Why? We have been voted, I think the last 8 years, 10 years, as the most giving community of our size in the nation. So we have a lot of companies that are looking for that volunteerism. And then connections. While LinkedIn says you can have a minimum of 50 connections, In order to be SEO, you need a minimum of 300. Again, search engine optimized. I need you to be active on LinkedIn. Now, people tell me all the time, well, I don't have time to be on LinkedIn 24/7, but you're on TikTok for 24/7. You're on Facebook for 24/7. You know, you're everywhere else, but you're not on LinkedIn. I'm not looking for 24/7. What I'm looking for is about 15 minutes per week. Once you get your profile optimized, okay? Now, LinkedIn is not like Facebook, where you can go in and read a couple of things and like it. It doesn't mean anything. You have to engage so you can post. I used to write articles all the time for LinkedIn and post them. Not so much anymore, but what I do is I comment on a post. So I'll see a post from one of my connections or one of the people I'm following, and I'll comment on that post. Add a branding picture. Okay, that branding picture is the one picture that's right behind your head on your screen. Put something that is engaged to you. If you take a look at mine, it's an old typewriter. It's a ledger because I'm old school, all right? Or add a branding video. At the beginning of COVID, I can't tell you how many branding videos or video resumes I helped people produce, all right? Not so much anymore because my fingers don't work like they used to, but it's something that you can think about. Post articles about your industry, about you. Interesting fun fact, people. And then tag and hashtag. We'll talk a little bit more about tagging in a few. Comment. Again, liking an article does not add SEO to your status. Comment and tag the author. Or tag others. Okay, the branding picture behind your headline, we've already talked about, and then you use a branding video like Loom or OBS, Open Broadcast Software. Now, Loom is fairly intuitive. It's just like Zoom, but it's Loom. All right, so it's pretty easy to do. OBS is more complicated, okay, but it works very, very well, all right? Being found, really simple. Join groups, join industry groups, join job search group, join St. Louis Job Angels. That's my job group. Got about 8,000 people strong, and about 40% are recruiters, HR, talent acquisition folks, people who are looking for you. This morning, five recruiters posted brand new jobs on my group, all right? So there's opportunities. Now, once you join that group, if it's a nationwide group with, you know, 25,000 people in it, this is gonna be kind of hard to do, but if it's a local group or a smaller group, my recommendation is as soon as you join and you're approved to join that group, then I would look at the group membership list. Go down that list and look for anybody with a title, recruiter, HR, talent acquisition, community or diversity in their job title, all right? It's really simple, and then connect with them. Write them a short little note. Say, hey, I see we're both in St. Louis Job Angels, and I'd love to be able to follow you on LinkedIn. Please connect with me. Whatever you want to say, however you want to say, all right? LinkedIn prioritizes showing posts to your first, second, and third degree connections whenever posting or if you're searching for advanced features on LinkedIn. Many LinkedIn users connect with every possible person they can find, aside from the clearly spammy type profiles. While this is yet to be tested, I'm of the opinion this can potentially weaken your profile. as you will become associated with profiles outside your industry, making it less likely for your profile to be associated with your target keywords. Now, again, untested, but at one time I was over 6,000 connections and I started seeing a lot of things that weren't connected to me. When I went in and I culled down to 1,500 connections, what I started to see was everything that I had built up before started showing up. So while, yes, I'm not saying not to connect with people, just make sure that a majority of your connections are within your industry or within your focus. Okay? In town, your profile is looking great. I get these from LinkedIn all the time. Your work and accomplishments are being recognized. You had 136 profile views. Who cares? I don't. And really, this is, I don't want to say propaganda. What they want you to do is to push that little blue donut in the middle that says, see who's looking. And because you may or may not have a business account or a professional LinkedIn account, you have the freebie, all right? What they want to do is have you optimize your profile by purchasing an account. It's entirely up to you. People ask me all the time, should I pay for LinkedIn? The answer, in my opinion, is no, unless you're a power user. For 10 years, I paid for a LinkedIn profile. Did it give me anything more than I have today? Not really, all right? But that's entirely up to you. Understanding your analytics. No optimization guide is worth its weight without showing results in terms of cold, hard numbers. That's why I was sure to test all of the LinkedIn best practices I encountered, as well as optimization hacks that I came up with on my own. I recommend that job seekers do the same. And we're going to show you a couple of things today. As LinkedIn optimization is still not very cut and dry, remember, LinkedIn is owned by Microsoft. How many times have you turned on your computer and your computer hasn't worked? Because it's Microsoft. So not saying there's a direct correlation there, but, all right? But the success of your LinkedIn strategy also depends on what works best for you. LinkedIn offers you a rather limited, but enough data to see how your profile is performing. You can see how many people have viewed your profile, how many have viewed your posts, how many people have you connected with, and how often have you appeared in the search results, just like I showed you a second ago. You can also see who's viewed your profile unless they have a protected account, but you have to examine these trends over time. Like I said, for 10 years, I tracked my profile on LinkedIn. I looked at all the analytics I could muster, as well as some of the ones that I developed myself. Okay, and again, that led me to the idea of paying for LinkedIn was not my optimal use. However, if you're a power user, or if you're a business, or if you're in media and marketing, it might be to your advantage. However, if you're a job seeker, it may not necessarily be to your advantage. That's your personal decision. So if you log into your LinkedIn profile and you click your picture, and you're going to get a bunch of great information. If you scroll down about a quarter way down the screen, you're going to run into this. Analytics. So what you're going to see here is 79 profile views. In other words, people who came across your feed. All right. And then 163 post impressions. What that means is those are people who read my post on LinkedIn. And then I showed up in 36 search appearances, right? Which means that somebody did a search and I showed up in those results. In order to look behind the picture, if you click these links, you will be able to see what's going on in your analytics. But again, remember, this is, if you do it once today, and then you never do this again, you're not seeing trends, all right? So you need to kind of do your homework a wee bit. So top 10 companies your searchers work at. So Anthem, Washington U, Army, Navy. Okay, now I work with a lot of veterans, so that shows that's good for me. Wash U, I follow Wash U. All right, so when their recruiter did a search, I'm assuming that I showed up there. All right. Top titles. So career counselors, that's what I am. So that's great for me to see those. All right, human resources. They're the ones that can connect with me. Business owners, corporate trainers, and again, I are one, and then transportation specialists. And I can understand that one, why? Because I was at the transportation board meeting here in the region, and so I had several people connect. All right, so this is what I'm looking for. When I look at these numbers, my question is not who's looking at me, but can they give me a job? So if I'm looking at this, so I got Anthem, Wash U, Army, Navy, okay, Medtronic. What that is telling me, other than the Army and the Navy, because I'm being 111 years old, they're not gonna hire me. But the other three organizations have opportunities for me. And then if we go one step further, career counselors, HR, business owners, trainers, all of those individuals can connect me with opportunities. So that's what I'm looking for. Is my outreach on LinkedIn reaching the people I want to connect with? Based on this just quick analytical review, the answer is, yes. So if we take a look at my profile again, what I have is I have a picture and, you know, it's nothing fancy, but it's a headshot. Okay. I don't want to see a picture of you standing in front of your Mercedes pointing at it because it doesn't do me any good. But again, old school, ledger, typewriter. Okay, book, and you go from there. Here's my headline, military liaison, business developer, public speaker, trainer, workforce development, and more importantly, veteran, or most important. Okay, now, a lot of people ask me, why don't I have that little green circle around my picture that says open to work? You can certainly turn that feature on. It'll tell you right at the bottom of the screen that you have that opportunity to turn it on. I need to caution you. Well, not caution you, that's kind of a bad term. The only people that can see it or search for it rather are people who are using LinkedIn Recruiter. Okay, so I don't use it, so I would never search on that. But if my company did, and one of the companies I worked for a couple of years ago, they had LinkedIn Recruiter, so I could actually search on them. So while it's nice, there's other things that you can do to broadcast them. All right, so six quick tips. Number one, reorder your skills. When I look at your profile, I'm just gonna skim down your profile. I'm gonna see if you have a picture. If you don't have a picture, there's a good chance I'm gonna keep going. Why? Because you haven't completed your profile. All right, I'm gonna look at your headline. All right, because I wanna know if you have the skills that I'm looking for. I'm going to look at the first 300 characters of your about section. Why? Because I have to push C more in order to read the whole thing, and I'm not. As I'm scrolling down, I'm going to look at your employment. I don't care where you worked or when you worked. I want to know if those job titles are similar to the positions that I'm hiring for. So I'm only going to look at your job titles. Then as I scroll down to your education, I'm going to pass your skills. What top three skills is on your LinkedIn profile now? Okay, is it Excel, PowerPoint, Microsoft Word? Oh, this person is a clerk, right? All right, I have people in the room going, yeah, you're right, you know, so, but that's okay. Here's the thing. Pick the top three skills that describe you best. That's not software, unless you're a software developer. Okay, that's not a task. Okay. And that's not a soft skill. All right. Look at mine, community outreach. That's where I live. All right. So kind of keep that in mind because I'm scrolling your profile. And if I see those public speaking, you know, community outreach, those skills that I bring to the table that's outside my normal job business, it makes people stop and pay attention. Update your headshot. Talked about this a little bit ago. Make sure you're wearing the appropriate attire. All we're looking for is a headshot, all right? Make sure your skills are up to date. Again, remove outdated skills, all right? Update your profile cover art. I don't care what you put. Show business, show industry, a personal interest. I see about 600 to 700 profiles all the time with the arts behind it. All right, I know everybody loves the arch. I've lived in St. Louis for more than 30 years and I've never been to the arch. Yeah, everybody's going, what? That's true, okay. It's not that I'm afraid of heights, I'm just afraid of arches, all right? So here's the deal. This needs to showcase who you are, all right? Number five, post, comment, and follow. Follow smart people. All right. People ask me, well, who should I follow? Somebody in your industry, somebody that you admire. I follow 40 people. Figured that I'd be following millions. No, I only know 40 smart people. The rest, I'm not sure about. Set a reminder, 15 minutes per week to keep active. All right, let's talk about post, comment. It's really simple. What we need to do is to make sure that what you bring to the table is appropriate. So a couple of weeks ago, I posted on LinkedIn about this workshop. Okay, and then what I did is I tagged a half a dozen people. That tag, what that does by doing the at sign, putting a name out there, that brings their network and my network together. Okay, so some of you all know Bob Koff. He's got about 5,000 connections. You know, I've got 3,800 connections, I think. So those are just first connections. So between me and Bob, we have almost 1 million first and second connections on LinkedIn. What does that mean? When I tagged him and then he responds and tags me back, that ups our views and our active status on LinkedIn. All right, so rather than just liking an article, tag. All right, on that. And we'll talk a little bit more about that as we move forward as well. And again, don't forget, set a reminder. Let's talk about how to find people. How many of you all, and this is a rhetorical question, how many of you all are submitting cover letters when you apply for a job? Yeah, okay. We got one person raised their hand, nobody else. But it, again, it's only just a rhetorical question. And I ask, why aren't you submitting a cover letter? And 8 times out of 10, I don't know who to address it to. Okay. So what we need to do is let's find the right people. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to find these people on LinkedIn. All right. So what we need to do is do a Boolean search within LinkedIn. All right. Now, anything within 2 words. So let me give you an example. A keyword or a search term is anything from 1 to 4 words that means the same thing. So if I'm going to look for a talent acquisition person, I need to quote talent acquisition so that the search engine within LinkedIn makes that one word. Otherwise, if you don't quote it, it's going to look for everything with talent and everything with acquisition, and it's not going to give you the results you're looking for. However, if I'm looking for recruitment, recruiter, diversity, or even recruiting, that's only one word, I don't have to quote. All right, so here's our HR suggestion. So you can do HR or human resources generalist or human resources or even sourcer. All right, now people always say, well, I need to go to the top. No, you don't. Why? Chances are when you get to business partner or HR partner or HR senior talent manager, those people can't give you a job. You need to target people that can move you forward in your job search strategy. So what we want to do now is add this search string to LinkedIn. So what you're going to do is right there by the end, you have our search string. So we're going to type in human resources generalist, and again in quote, talent acquisition, quote, and you can make this as long or as short as you want. My recommendation is you keep it as short as possible. So typically, I wouldn't group 2 of these searches together. I would just group like human resources generalist, or I would just search for talent acquisition, right? What this is going to do is going to give me 47,000 results. Now, keep in mind, my results and your results going to be different. Why? It's because of LinkedIn. All right. Now keep in mind that a good 40 to 45% of my connections are HR, talent acquisition, recruiters, sourcers, all of these people. So I'm going to get different results if you're only connected to a handful of these. All right. But notice right above the arrow. We now have filters. So the first thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna click on connections. Now, do not check first connections. Why? You're already connected to those. So check second connections. Why not third? Because you have to have an email address for third connections, but not second. So hit second connections, show results. Then you're going to reduce your connections, the number of your results. Now, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to change locations. So here, I'm going to change it to Greater St. Louis. Why? Because that's going to give me the MSA. That's going to give me St. Louis City, St. Louis County, St. Charles County, all right? Also, Jefferson and Franklin County, but it would also give me Madison, Macoupin, and St. Clair counties. So it gives me a 30 to 45 minute drive from my house to make this greater St. Louis area. All right. And then I am going to show results. And now if you take a look, I'm down to 467. So out of all of the St. Louis County, I'm only not connected to 467. Talent acquisition recruiters, or what did I put in? I did talent or human resource generalist. All right, pretty cool, huh? Absolutely. So now you can't tell me you can't find these people. So let's take this one more step. Click current company. All right. And what I've done here is you have the ability to add a company. What I'm going to do is check there, show results, and now I am at 12. Okay. So again, you cannot tell me you can't find these people. Pretty cool, huh? Like it, I do, it works. It's real simple. I've given you how to search. I've given you what to search for. Now, all you have to do is apply. Now, keep in mind that, let's say maybe you live in Springfield, Illinois, and you're not interested in the greater St. Louis area. All right, then type in your location. Now, keep in mind though, if you put a small town or a smaller community, I live in North County, St. Louis. If I were to put that, this is an idiot box. It's only going to give you that. So you want to make that search area as broad as you possibly can. Okay? Cool. So the next thing we can do is we can add a career break. This is brand new, it's only a couple of years old. So let's say you needed to take time off to take care of a loved one, to go to school, just to take some personal time for you. Like when I retired from the Air Force, I took 2 years off to learn every Barney song in the world. Okay, so I wish LinkedIn would have had a career break back then, but again, this is only a couple of years old. So if you go into LinkedIn and look at the job section, you can add a career break. Fill in the blanks. You can put a start date and you can even put an end date. All right. So I added a career break, voluntary work in St. Louis, and I ended it in January. What did it do? I don't know. Once I loaded it, I had a lot of people came back to me and said, hey, Frank, what are you doing? Are you still doing workshops? So even though I was on a break, everybody still connected with me. So, but I just think it's nice, all right? If you need to take time for you, all right? LinkedIn secrets, what you are not doing today. I have this undying feeling here that we are not doing something. So number one thing, tagging. Being active is a key function of being found. All right, if I were to take a look at your LinkedIn profile today and notice you haven't done anything, you are gonna show up further and further in the search results. So what does that mean? It's really simple. I'm a recruiter. I do a search on LinkedIn. I'm probably gonna look at the first 50 to 100 people. And if you're 101, I don't get to you. What does that mean? You're a ghost. LinkedIn is not like other social media sites. Liking a post only shows it to the first connections who are active. Okay, so if I liked your post, it shows up to the guy or the person, the author of the post. And it might show up in my feed, but I'm not sure. So what I want to do is I want you to start tagging. All right. So here's my WashU tag. So yes, I liked it. But what I want to do is I want to combine my first and second connections with the tagged individual's first and second connections. All right. Now, there's one problem with tagging on LinkedIn. It's limited to taggable active connections. So sometimes you want to tag somebody and they don't show up in your feed. Now there could be 100 different reasons they don't show up, but try it anyway. All right, please limit the number of times you tag somebody. I had one individual for a year. Every time they tagged, I was part of the tag. Now, after the first couple of times, it was okay. But when I'm getting tagged 8, 10, 15 times a week, it gets a little redundant. Okay, so just kind of keep that in mind. I'm not telling you not to do it. I'm just letting you know what happens to the person you're tagging. All right? So here's real simple. All you have to do is in the comment, put the at sign. And what it's going to do is it's going to bring a list of people up. The first person on that list is the author of that article. So click their name because you want to give them kudos for their post. So click the link. Now, I'll tell you a little secret. There's an alphabet hack. So if you type the A, after the at sign, you will see that has an A in it. Not everybody, but you know, 20, 30 people. Yeah, active people, correct. Now, if you type a B, you'll get a list of Bs. Cs, Ds, Es. And I can tell you, in my 15 minutes of fame every week, what I will do is I will do A, pick somebody like Vito, all right, Alu, and then I'll put at B and scroll down and find somebody in the B's and then C's. I typically don't tag more than five people plus the author. Okay, but I have friends and connections that will tag 15 to 20 people plus the author. So you decide, but tagging brings your network and their network to the table. And that's what you're looking for. It ups your searchability. In other words, that I can find you. Job search. Have you ever received a job notification and wondered why LinkedIn sent it to you? I got one the other day that said, you match zero percent of the qualifications. Why? I don't know. It's LinkedIn. All right. LinkedIn only shows you jobs based on your profile. And if your profile is not keyword rich, it's not going to send you there. All right. LinkedIn advanced search feature, where you can go in and look for jobs on LinkedIn, again, will only show you jobs based on your profile, limited results, and displayed positions. All right, that's why I go to Google. Why? Google knows all and sees all. Okay, except for Baidu in China, but that's because we don't use China's search engine. So what we're going to do is we're going to type in this search into Google. This will work limited in Safari and Firefox. And what's that other one, Brave? And there's a couple others that will give you limited results. Bing, or Edge, it doesn't work with it hardly at all. Why? Because it's script. So type in site colon linkedin.com and then parentheses, put your search term. What job you're looking for. Then put space minus senior space minus partner. Why? Unless you're a C-suite person, you don't want those jobs. Correct? Just say yes, because I know that's correct. Except for me. I want a job that pays me a lot of money that I don't have to do anything with. All right, so you can look here. We got 22 million results. So what does this mean? Absolutely nothing, because nobody here is going to look at 22 million results. Plus, that 22,900,000 results, about 22,850,000 results are ads. Oh, I shouldn't have said that out loud. Okay. So, but we made a mistake in this search. Take a look at this. Notice I put minus space senior, right? Versus space minus senior, right? So I added an extra space. So look at the first result, 174 senior recruiter jobs. Because our search parameters were off by that space between minus and the senior. So be cognizant of how you're uploading this. So we redid our search terms and I added location, colon, in parentheses, St. Louis. Because I started to notice a lot of these jobs were overseas, right? Which really doesn't mean that big of a deal in today's remote jobs availability. But what I really like about these results is 56 technical recruiter jobs, new, posted the same day. I like that. Now, I did the exact same search in LinkedIn, and LinkedIn showed me 14 jobs. You decide. Do you remember when we used to use business cards? Yep. How many of you all have business cards now? Now, we're slowly getting back to that. How long has it been since you've shaken somebody's hand? I left this in because I'm still doing workshops via Zoom, like today. Okay, let alone giving somebody a business card. Instead, immediately we connect on LinkedIn. Majority of the people that come to my workshop, if we're not already connected, I want to say 7 out of 10 times, I will get a connection from you or them within the next 3 to 4 days. When hiring in a remote world, the likelihood you'll never even meet your connections in person is pretty high. Just did an interview 2 months ago for a job in Europe at the EU, but it was 100% remote. They said, once a year, we will send you someplace over in the European Union for our grand annual ball, and we'll pay for you to come. I can't even spell you, so I'm not sure. What else do you do but to keep in connection with them digitally? How many of you have interviewed or started the interview process and tried to connect with the person you're interviewing with on LinkedIn? Yes, kind of, maybe, hopefully. All right. And that's what you need to do. Now, a lot of people say, well, Frank, that's great. Who is your actual LinkedIn target? You want to connect with the right people. You need to think about who your audience is on LinkedIn. After leadership within a corporation has exhausted their current company's internal promotions, as well as their own personal network, they'll put pressure on the internal HR teams or internal corporate recruiters to find the perfect candidate. The number one person you are targeting is human resources, recruiters, and diversity and community outreach folks at those organizations. Curate your profile. The overall appearance of your profile should be clean, easy to read so that the recruiter can have an understanding of you personally, your personality and experience quickly. LinkedIn is not your resume, it's you. Make sure you have high quality images. Your average recruiter reviews hundreds of profiles every day, and you need to make sure that yours is the one they choose to look at most. Build the right network. A lot of you have seen this in the past, and I'll show it to you again. This is my network. Make it work for you. Okay? Shameless plug. November 22nd, I'm going to be doing resume development at our sister site in St. Charles County. November 29th. Online applications and basic LinkedIn. But this is a big one. On December 8th, here, it's going to be Ask Frank Day. This is where I'm going to ask all of you to bring your questions to the table. All right. I will be sitting down in front of the laptop. I'm not going to be doing a presentation. What we're going to do is hopefully utilizing the library's resources and my skills and knowledge, we're going to help you solve your job search dilemma. Okay? Questions? I have the wrong picture. I sure do. That's St. Charles Library. Here we go. My favorite quote, hitchhikers may be escaping inmates. We all learn something new every day. And I'm hoping that today you learned a little bit more about LinkedIn, more importantly, how to make your profile SEO.